So you want to win an NCAA championship. Some think it's easy, and on paper, maybe it is. Just win the next six games in a row, and you've reached your goal. But as Dickie V is going to tell you, these are the toughest six games to play. And you'll see that in today's game between the Bradley Braves and the Michigan State Spartans.
Hey, Brad, the NCAA tournament is the reward. After a long season of practices, tough games, and all of those other rigors, the tournament is their pinnacle.
The Spartans should be able to run away with this one, Dick Vitale.
Hey, what are the keys for them doing so? The keys are pretty simple, Brad. First, I look at the point guard to step up tonight and really take control of his club. Second of all, reward your big men for running the court. Get him some easy buckets in transition. Thirdly, make good passes and force the other team to play honest defense.
Well, Dick, let's get this one started and see what happens. Both teams looking to get things going here. Gave it up. He shoots from right of the circle. He missed. Number 20 receives the ball. Dickie's doing a nice job defensively fronting him.
Well, it's the key is to really beat him to the spot, get help from the help side, and really do a great job seeing ball and man. Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
Isolated on the outside. They're working around the arc, looking for the open jumper. He takes the shot off the baseline. Drains it. He keeps his dribble as they reset. Looking for contact. Number 20 makes the finger roll. Moving it around the perimeter. Got to give that five-second call to the defense.
Trying to execute on the inbounds.
Got a man in high post. Fires away. Number 14 is emotionally fired up.
And you know what, Brad? I'm excited for him. He's putting on a performance.
Gets the rejection. He stays in control until they regroup the offense. Ball was knocked loose, but the offense got it back. Can't get the shot to drop. Patience with the ball as the offense regroups. Now trying to feed the low block. There they come with a double team to stop it. Our three-prong attack tonight, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Brad Nessler with Dick Vitale and our friend EA Aaron Andrews checking in from the sideline.
I'll tell you, he missed the post guy. The post guy had the great angle, was locking on a box.
Number 22, pump fakes. Ball comes back out from the post.
I tell you, Brad, you got to have a post player that anticipates and knows how to find the open man.
They go into the low block, tries for two. He's making just terrible choices shooting the ball.
He's got to settle down, man. Settle that cat down.
Working around the perimeter. Goes for the deep one. Scorches the net. Down inside for two. And he missed.
Trying to go inside.
And they do. They got on the low block. And the ball goes out of bounds. Showing maturity by waiting for the O to regroup. The small forward receives the pass. The fake. Here's a double team. He shoots from the top of the key. The Spartans have found a player who cannot seem to miss, Dick.
They need to keep feeding the ball. It's simple. Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps. He's doing a terrible job of distributing the ball.
They may have to pull him out and let somebody else out there and let him think about it for a while. Nice job to create the angle using the glass.
Trying to feed the low block. Great steal. I think the pressure was just too much.
Tremendous pressure, just enough to force the steal.
He lets it go. The Spartans have got to continue to get him the ball.
Brady's on fire.
Entry pass in the paint.
That was a high post screen. Goes to the lane.
Perfectly executed. Runs him first, Dick, and then works behind.
Yeah, he's playing from behind him because that tells me right there they don't respect him as an offensive player.
And has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that block shot.
Time to pick up the defense here now. Work the perimeter.
Spacing's so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
The dribble, gives it up, goes up for two.
Great play to take that to the basket.
Let's go to the third member of our broadcast team. Here's Aaron Andrews.
Well, Brad and Dick, both teams appear to be really focused as they return to their benches. This is it for one of these teams, and as you guys frequently say, it's do or die, guys.
Number 54 goes to the line. He gets it to go. The post flashes up high if he wants it. Defensively doing a great job down there, and he's winning that battle there.
I think it's very essential that you establish post position by moving that offensive player out, and that's how he's winning that battle.
He missed on the steal. That's going to be the offense's game.
Yes, sir. They got the advantage right there once he misses that gamble.
Gave it up.
Great anticipation defensively.
Bradley are showing signs of a good run here, Dick.
They look like they put it together for a moment. Hey, let's see how long they can keep it up.
We're about ready to hit the floor. Terrible execution on offense. Number 20 handles the pass. Now they work it around the perimeter. Obvious foul. That one puts the personal in personal. Picks up the foul.
I tell you, poor play defensively. Look at the facial expression.
He's got a high post flasher. On the dribble, gives it up. Takes away the pass. They work the perimeter. Gave it up. He shoots from right of the circle. Way off target. Down in the low post defensively. Great anticipation in the steal.
You can see they did a great job studying in film. They anticipated that ball coming to that post.
The replay reveals the deal, baby.
On the outside, the power forward handles the feed, and he scores despite the hack. The skip pass is picked off. On the dribble, gives it up. He beats him to the punch defensively.
What a terrific job. Footwork really excellent on a post play.
On the inside. That spin move's not going to work against this defense.
That's a no-no, baby. Defensive player beats him to the spot.
Number five takes it away. Jumps into the defender. Up! Easy one.
Dump it inside.
For the bucket. Can't get the shot to go. There was no doubt about that one. Let's see if they go two for one here, Dick. Tries for two.
They let him get into a rhythm.
Look at that spacing.
Shots there if he wants it. With the block. Got a wide open look. Shoots it. Off the rim and no good. Shot clock is dead. Thinks about the shot. Strips the ball. With a deep pass. Goes up for two. Goes in. At the end of the first half, the Spartans are trailing by 10. Number 41 has played a pretty good game, but pretty good isn't going to be enough to help him on the scoreboard tonight, I don't think.
I think he's taking what the opposition has given him and not being aggressive enough. Look for him to be more assertive in the second half.
Let's check in courtside with Aaron Andrews. Aaron?
Well, Brad and Dick, as you can imagine, both coaches were very intense as I met with them at halftime. They said at this point, it all comes down to playing their game, having fun, and enjoying the moment, guys.
Thanks, Aaron. Dumps it in. Picks off the pass. The shooting guard takes the feed. Off the rim and no good. Both teams looking to get things going here. Here's the offensive drop step in the low block, but better defense.
I'll tell you, the defense doesn't allow him to get to the baseline.
Rips down the rebound.
They need to get out and run their lanes now.
Looking for a good shot. The ball goes out of bounds. High post flashes for the ball handler. Looking to move it around the perimeter. Takes away the pass. For two. He gets the bucket. They move it into the front court. Number 22 comes up with it. Passed on the guy in the post to go the other way. Too physical. And there's a look at the backcourt comparison, Dick.
I'll tell you, Brad, you always want to know how the primary ball handlers are doing. Are they getting their team's quality shots, good opportunities? The team which takes care of these things usually is in a better position to win a game.
Rims out.
Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important on how talented guards are there.
Yeah, that helps. That's probably why you're out of coaching. Too many points off turnovers.
I'll tell you one thing. That leads you to the exit sign. No question. You get the Ziggy. I'll tell you, you got to protect the basketball. You can't turn it over.
The Ziggy. I love that. Gets his second. Some contact. Bradley are on a bit of a run.
Let's see how long they can keep it on, Brad.
Takes the pass in the paint.
Tempo of the game really important here. You want to establish some good tempo.
The defender right on his hip, and I think he's holding his ground, Dick.
Doing a great job. I tell you, doing a phenomenal job not allowing the offensive player to seal him off. Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
He dials long distance. Do they need a timeout here?
Yeah, their poise is beginning to fade. He's got to pass it or make a play, Brad.
I can't believe there wasn't a whistle on that one.
Yeah, it should have been a whistle right there. I thought there was definitely an offensive charge.
They'd like to get it inside to the low block. Unable to so far. Nice job of packing it in defensively.
Yeah, really doing a great job packing it in and a great job of anticipating that lateral pass.
For the deuce, he keeps the concentration off the contact for the score. On the outside. Looking for a good shot. Steals the pass. They work it around the arc. Tries for two. And off the mark. Playing for the steal in the post, and he didn't get it.
I'll tell you, tried to make the spectacular play, but now he's embarrassed.
Buried it. Trying to come up with a steal, and they do. For the bucket. Dick, they really need to get something going in a hurry here.
Yeah, call a timeout and get your boys into the game, Brad. Double team now, bad angle.
Let's go courtside. What do you got for us, Aaron?
Well, Brad and Dick, a sense of urgency down here on the bench. The coaching staff is starting to sense their players are starting to panic, and they want that stopped before any further damage is done. Guys?
All right, thanks, Aaron. Tries for two. The layup is good.
That's a 7-0 run.
Looking for a good shot. For the bucket. He puts it in with contact and all. Picked off. Pushes it up. The shooting guard takes the pass.
Hey, did you see what the mascot was doing after the last dunk? Was he excited or what? He was jumping all over the place.
Defense! 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 entry pass in the paint.
I think right now, gotta focus defensively.
There's the fake. He strips him clean. And again, they look to run.
Poor job offensively. I'm coaching. He's sitting next to me as an assistant coach. He's pounding the ball to the deck. Where's he going?
The shooting guard with the ball. From left of the circle, way off target. Number 14 with the foul. The momentum is on their side. High fives, chest bumps. We're seeing all that.
Hey, why not? It's a team sport, right?
And a momentary look from three-point land. Fakes the shot. And has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
And the ball goes out of play. What a great play. Check him out, Nick. He's taunting the crowd.
Brad, the players are feeling it, and they want everyone to know that they're feeling it.
Nick, a great battle down in the low post, but I think the offense is gaining ground here.
Yeah, he's getting great inside position, has a great angle. He's got him set up perfectly for a basket. They got the 45-degree angle, which is essential in entering the ball to the post. Hey, Brad, you want to get to the line early and often. You end up getting your opponents into foul trouble, and it's also an opportunity to get some points.
Makes his second shot. Moving it around the perimeter. For two. Doesn't go. He intercepts it. The point guard gets the ball. Work the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
Isolated on the outside. They work it around the arc, looking for the open jumper. Here they go into the break.
It looks as though they have a shooter spotting up.
In the paint. He strips him clean. The perimeter intercepted, goes up for two, off the rim and no good. Trying to draw the foul, drops the bucket despite the harm. Let's check in with Erin Andrews and what she's got in store for us. Erin.
Well, guys, the battle in the paint has played a major factor in this game and is probably some of the reason why they have this lead. If things don't change in a hurry, this game could get ugly, guys.
I think she's right about that, Richie.
I'll tell you, Ernie's exactly right. Post play is essential if you're going to be effective.
This one could be over.
That's all she wrote.
And has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
Poor decision there to shoot that three.
Yeah, that's horrible, Mr. Nestler. Horrible shot selection.
He goes for three. That's an ill-advised shot. I don't think that's the guy you want shooting from the three-point line.
I don't think the coach wants him taking that shot.
Spacing.
Had him in the low block, but opted against it. He shoots from left of the circle for two. Was that beautiful or what? Goes up for two. He's money with the shot. A little one-man backcourt pressure. He uses the shot fake.
Very soft defensively, no pressure on a basketball.
And with that, there's going to be some open jumpers if they don't pick up defensively. This young man means so much to this team, and the fans just love him.
He means so much to the program. He's a consistent performer and always competes at a high level.
Oh, and he's not going to be happy with that call.
Well, silly foul right there, but look at his face. His facial expression tells it all.
There's a double team waiting there. at the perimeter. Strips the ball. Shot clock is dead. He goes for the trifecta. Rims out. He takes the shot from the baseline. For the deuce. Perfectly executed. Gave it up. The small forward gets the pass. Dick, you've said it so many times, survive and advance. Well, one survived and will advance. The other one's going home.
Well, I tell you, they won this game, Brad, when you look at it and analyze it, because they really had all the right people shoot the ball at the right moment. They did a terrific job offensively.
Bradley came, they saw, and they conquered their first-round foe, Dick.
I tell you, Brad, watch out for this team, because the coach has these kids playing with more intensity than they ever did during a regular season. And I'm going to tell you, it's going to serve them well, as now they shift into gear for that second-round matchup.
Brad Nessler saying so long for my partners, Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews. Thanks for joining us.